Hello to you from ChemHelp ASAP. This video describes the recently approved drug TRYVIO. This video is a broad overview of the drug's physicochemical and medicinal chemistry properties rather than the clinical pharmacology of the drug. TRYVIO was approved by the FDA on the 19th of March in 2024. TRYVIO is the brand name of the drug, the final drug product in the form administered to the patient. The international non-proprietary name of the active pharmaceutical ingredient, the drug substance, is aprocitentan. TRYVIO is approved for oral administration once daily with a 12.5 milligram dose. TRYVIO treats hypertension and is approved for use in combination with other antihypertensive drugs. This condition is sometimes called resistant hypertension, though this condition is not specifically named in the prescribing information. The NDA applicant was Idorsia Pharmaceuticals. Since TRYVIO is to be used with other antihypertensives, let's talk about some antihypertensive drug classes. On this slide are six drug classes for antihypertensives, along with one or more representative examples of specific drugs within each class. The prescribing information insert for TRYVIO in the clinical studies section specifically mentions that patients in phase 3 trials were taking angiotensin receptor blockers, calcium channel blockers, diuretics, and/or beta blockers. These were taken in addition to TRYVIO. So, in theory, TRYVIO should fit within the treatment regimen of many patients currently on hypertension medications. Note that most of these classes are named after the drug's mechanism of action. For example, the ACE inhibitors, which inhibit angiotensin-converting enzyme. TRYVIO acts on a different target from any of the drugs on this slide. TRYVIO acts on the endothelin receptor. The endothelin receptor is a GPCR in vascular smooth muscle cells. The endogenous ligand is endothelin 1, ET1. There are multiple subtypes of the endothelin receptor, A, B1, B2, and C, with the A and B forms being more well studied. Aprocitentan, the API in TRYVIO, is an endothelin receptor antagonist. So endothelin receptors are associated with responses of vasoconstriction and retention of sodium. As an antagonist, aprocitentan reduces vasoconstriction and retention of sodium and thereby plays a role in reducing a patient's blood pressure. Here are some data on binding to endothelin receptors. These data are from the Guide to Pharmacology. So the endogenous ligand, endothelin 1, has an EC50 of around 10 nanomolar for the endothelin A receptor. The value range corresponds to slightly different results being seen in different vascular tissues. Aprocitentan has an IC50 value of around 3.2 nanomolar for the endothelin A receptor. I admit that you can't directly compare the EC50 and IC50 values, but I think these numbers show that the target binding of both endothelin 1 and aprocitentan for the ETA receptor are fairly comparable. This table shows the simple physicochemical properties of aprocitentan. For an oral drug, the molecular weight is somewhat high at nearly 550 grams per mole. That's not a huge surprise given the structure has two bromines, which add 160 grams per mole by themselves. Otherwise, the various metrics are completely within expectations of an oral drug. Let's see how these physicochemical properties and the structure of aprocitentan translate into the observed pharmacokinetics of the compound. These are the key PK parameters. I want to start in the upper right, bioavailability. I said that the physicochemical properties of aprocitentan are consistent with an oral drug, but the prescribing information does not report an oral bioavailability. Since it is now an approved oral drug, the oral absorption is clearly good enough to achieve efficacious exposures in patients. Okay, back on track to half-life. The half-life is quite long at 41 hours. In the prescribing information, the clearance is reported as 0.3 liters per hour, which I calculate as 0.07 milliliters per minute per kilogram of patient mass based on a 70 kilogram patient. The volume of distribution is 20 liters or 0.29 liters per kg of patient mass. While the volume of distribution is not remarkably high or low, the clearance, however, is very low. The low clearance allows us to explain the long half-life of aprocitentan. We can mathematically understand the long half-life based on low clearance, but how can we understand the long half-life from a structural basis? First, look in the bottom right corner of the slide. The amount of drug excreted unchanged by the kidneys is negligible. So renal clearance is negligible, essentially zero. In general, clearance, that's total clearance, is the sum of renal clearance and hepatic clearance. If renal clearance is zero, then total clearance is essentially equal to hepatic clearance. So for aprocitentan, if total clearance is very low, then hepatic clearance must also be very low, meaning the rate of metabolism is also very low. If we look at aprocitentan, there are not many obvious sites for metabolism. Aprocitentan doesn't have many soft spots. Its relative resistance to metabolism reduces hepatic clearance. Total clearance is therefore very low, and the half-life is extended. Back to the lower right corner, while the parent drug is not excreted by the kidneys, there are metabolites that undergo renal excretion into the urine. What are these metabolites? The prescribing information notes two elimination pathways for aprocitentan. The drug undergoes glucuronidation, a phase 2 process shown in the top reaction. I'm comfortable that the glucuronide shown is the correct metabolite, but the reaction could also occur at the other NH group as well. The bottom reaction is even more speculative. It is a non-enzymatic hydrolysis, presumably a slow hydrolytic degradation in the aqueous environment of the body. Presumably, this hydrolysis involves the sulfamid group, although other options are also conceivable. So these metabolites are at least representative of the types of compounds that arise from aprocitentan reaction in the body. The top reaction is a metabolic process, and the bottom reaction is a degradation pathway. Aprocitentan does have some safety risks. The most notable is embryo-fetal toxicity. Just as this bullet point is in a box, aprocitentan carries a boxed warning for this particular safety risk. Rarely, patients may experience hepatotoxicity in the form of elevated liver enzyme levels as well as elevated total bilirubin. Other adverse reactions include fluid retention, a decrease in hemoglobin levels, and decreased sperm counts. That completes this discussion of TRYVIO, which was approved for the treatment of hypertension in conjunction with other antihypertensive drugs. TRYVIO was approved by the FDA on March 19th of 2024. Thank you for watching to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed this discussion of the recent FDA approval of TRYVIO. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.